The point of this video is going to be showing what Gemini can do in Google Sheets. It's August 2024. It's obviously early days for Gemini, but we're going to use some what I think are real world situations and see how Gemini can help. So the first thing that we're going to do, we'll let it do something I think it's going to be good at, which is just creating a sample spreadsheet. This is what you usually see in the marketing. And it may save time, but when I'm using spreadsheets, I don't spend most of my time creating them. I spend my time working inside of them, right? But this is a cool feature nonetheless. So we will click on Help Me Organize. This pops up when you've installed Gemini, which you can see here. So I'll click on this too. It just puts a sidebar up here. Let me try to clear out some of that. So we start fresh. Okay, so we will say, help me organize. And let's say I have a stock portfolio. Okay, I have three stocks and I want to keep track of them in Google Sheets. Let's say create a stock tracker for ATT, Abercrombie, and Beyond Meat. I have 10 shares of each, and I want the current market value. I think I was pretty specific, right? I haven't done a lot of training on exactly how to prompt AI because I don't think that's the point, right? It's supposed to make it easier. So you should be able to give it instructions and it just creates something for you. But it does only know what you type in. So as I go through this, I'll try not to expect it to read my mind. So it did create a stock tracker, all right? That's step one, that's good. It has a column for the ticker. So that's exactly what I wanted. So since I clicked in, it's asking if I wanted to insert. So we'll say yes. Ticker, the company name. So that's helpful, we'll keep that. Number of shares, current share price. So far so good. And current market value. So let's talk about what's in here. And we'll be a little bit picky because again, the point of this should be to save time, not to make cool things. If that's too practical and you just wanna have fun, maybe this is good, but let's critique this a little bit. So first of all, is I already told it how many shares I have. So why it added extra lines with different quantities of shares. That seems like a waste, right? So we would have to delete that. So we'll do that. It did put in a current share price, but it didn't use a formula. And Google Sheets has a built-in formula called Google Finance that goes to the web and looks up the current stock price. So this could have inserted Google Finance. It would take the ticker symbol and pull it in. But if you double click in the cell or if you look here in the formula bar, it didn't do that. It just put in a number. Now, maybe it looked up that number, but tomorrow that number is going to be wrong. So that is one limitation, is that it's not inserting formulas directly into Sheets at this point. And you'll see that again when you look at the current market value. So this is the math is right here, at least on this one, 10 times 20, 34 is 203.40. But if you get another share, that doesn't update because it didn't put formulas in E2. So to me, this is a strange limitation. If it's going to create a template and it has implied math behind it, I don't know why it would hard key the results. I would expect that to change in a future version, but it's where it is right now. So it's not putting in, I'll say, fancy formulas like Google Finance. It may not be that intuitive, but the user sees that formula, they could learn that it exists. And it's not putting in basic formulas like multiplication. Let's try to have it update it. Let's say, use the Google Finance function. I know what it's going to tell me because I may have recorded this video with the microphone off a few minutes ago and had to re-record it. But it's just not, yeah, so I couldn't create a formula for that request. Try being more specific. Okay, so use the Google Finance function. I just hit the up button there. For AT&T stocks current market price. I think that's enough data to create the Google Finance function. We shall see. But this is, well, it still can't do it. So I'm leading it down the road of telling it the exact function. So if I didn't know the name of that function and just said, do you have a function for share price? Let's try that. Do you have a function to look up share price? Hopefully it'll be able to tell us this so that we can look it up and use it on our own. Yeah, it can't. All right, so test number one for Gemini is that it created a decent template, right? But can't really help you out with it more than that. I think that's a fair statement. So for these next two tests, what I did was I was trying to, this was a hard video, I think, to make productive because you could do a million things with it. So I wanted to do was find out popular things that people can't quite figure out in a spreadsheet. And I think I have a good source of data for that because I can just go to the Google Sheets videos I've made over the last 10, 15 years, probably 10 years, and sort them by number of views, right? And one of the most popular ones is how to conditionally format a column based on another column. So what I want to do, I just want to highlight all of the units that Wilbur sold. Okay, so the word units is literally a header label here, so it should be able to figure that out. And Wilbur is one of the reps. Let's just bold this so you and I can see that that's a header row. So I know how to do the conditional formatting here. You could format and put in conditional formatting with a little formula. It's not super intuitive how it's done, and that's why people look at that video. But you should be able to ask Gemini to do it for you, right? So let's say highlight all entries in column D. No, let's say units. Highlight all units that Wilbur sold. Now it has to infer that this is a sales register, right? I don't use the word sold in here, so that may be a bit of a stretch, but it's AI, so it should be able to figure it out, right? If I hit enter and wait just a minute. All right, so it didn't, the word highlight, you know, it didn't respect or use that, because this won't highlight, but this will count, maybe. This is a weird formula, but I'm assuming it works. This formula looks through B2 and counts the instances of Wilbur. And it's already saying the formula result is zero. It didn't capitalize Wilbur. Maybe because when I typed it out, well, I'm gonna hit the up arrow here. I capitalized Wilbur, but it did not. Let's paste this function and see what happens. All right, so that's interesting. So I asked it to highlight and it didn't highlight. I knew it wouldn't because it can't, I don't think, actually write into the spreadsheet, strangely enough. It did give me a function, but the function doesn't work. Let's capitalize a W, still doesn't work. It gave me a function that doesn't work. And even if that did work, it wouldn't indicate the number of units, which is what I was getting at, I think, with that. So delete. I think it's fair to say that it can't do the conditional formatting, nor really did it get the spirit of the what I asked it here. So let's go to another popular question that people have is, how can I find duplicates in data? All right, and one of the popular solutions is to use conditional formatting. We know it can't do that, so we'll be fair. We'll ask it to do it in another way. So what we want to do is we want to insert an X in column D if one of these items is a duplicate. So we'll say, give me a formula, because I know it can't write it in there, to insert an X in column D if there is a duplicate in columns B and C. See if this works. Mm-hmm. think this was that difficult. Well, I said I wasn't going to cut this video, but I may speed this part up. Something went wrong, try again. So the first time I recorded this video when my microphone was off, to be fair, it did give the right formula. This time it didn't. So let's move on. Now let's see if it can come up with a formula that looks at this sheet and then sees if there's duplicates in the sheet called dupes two. So this would be whether or not it's aware of and able to work between sheets. So let's say insert an X in column D if, we'll just say last name. Last name is also on the dupes to sheet. Now I'm sure there's better ways to word these, but I think if Gemini is helpful, what it does is make Google Sheets more accessible to people who can't just come up with the right formula all the time, right? That's hard to do. Sheets or Gemini should be able to do it for us. Let's see if it, you know, with plain English inputs. So let's see if this worked. Okay, well, it did give us some feedback at least. It couldn't create a formula. Try being more specific. All right, let's say this. Look for dupe. How about this? Tell me if there are any duplicate names between the dupes one and dupes two sheets. I didn't say create a formula. I just said tell me. So it may create a formula. It may just tell me, or it may tell me it's not going to do anything. Ah, a real formula. Look at that. I can tell that formula right away for whatever reason is just looking at this spreadsheet. But let's just put this in here and see what it does. This is counting. It's not doing anything because I know, well, are there duplicates? I'm not sure if there are duplicates in here because the point of this was that there were some duplicates in this sheet. I'd say that is another instance in which this did not work. So let's do one more thing, and we're just going to get a little bit more creative. Well, not more creative. We're going to simulate a more predictable monthly exercise that you likely could be doing in an accounting or production department at work, right? So what we're doing is we're just maintaining inventory. So let's say we want to change something here. So let's say change the SOBI to 94. So I want to change this 95 to a 94. I didn't say the amount. I didn't say price. Probably could have been more specific. Let's try it again. But I think what it's going to say is it can't access the sheet. So this is going to show just the limitation of why is Gemini here? Occasionally you need to look up new formulas. I don't know what that is. Update, set, where? Like, that's not even a spreadsheet formula. That's another language. So Gemini, don't know what it's doing there. Let's say add another row of SOBI. I didn't tell it much to add, but it's AI, so it should just make up the rest. Oh, and maybe it did. So it gave me a query formula. Let's see what this formula does. Oh, yeah, this is kind of cool. So what it did was it gave me a formula that returns one more row. I don't know how it did that. Oh, so it created a query formula of this table here. So, and it output all of that, and then it just added a line to it. So it actually used a workaround to add another row. It created, and this table here is dynamic. So this first one says 52. If I were to update this, it would say 48, and it changed down here. Now, I think you can answer for yourself if someone in the inventory department would find that useful. I do think it's an interesting solution, but there are a couple other things to consider. So before, in my opinion, this becomes actually useful is one, it could write formulas into the sheet. You could use a phone and tell it what write formulas to write. Or in this case, inventory, there's a count sheet, right? You could hold the phone up with the camera to the count sheet. It reads it, updates the spreadsheet, adds a new one, whatever. You tell it what to do with it. But this is the current state of Gemini and Google Sheets. It may be helpful for you. If you try it, let me know in the comments how it goes for you. Thanks for watching. And this next video is going to show you a new capability in Google Sheets. It's very useful. It's called Tables. And I'll just give you a little preview. Let's take this data right here and we're going to format, convert to table. And you get all these extra capabilities since you did this. And I will show those in this next video. Thanks for watching.